the living world. The world of living organisms is wonderful. There are varieties of living organisms in the world. Some are flying, some are jumping, some are running, and like that. As we know, there are birds, mammals, and also microorganisms are there in the world. So the diversity of living organisms is amazing. See, various habitats of living organisms. Many organisms live in the evergreen forests, and many live under oceans. There are large number of organisms live on mountains, and many living things are seen even in the desert. See, the body of some organisms is made up of single cell. Such organisms are called unicellular organisms. You can see two examples here, Paramecium and amoeba. It has only one cell in its body. That is why we call this unicellular organism. There are large number of organisms whose body carry many cells. So, such organisms are called multicellular organisms. We have birds, we have zebras, frogs, and plants, etc., etc. These are all multicellular organisms. Again, there are two types of cells in the organisms, mainly prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Take for example, in the bacteria, there is a prokaryotic cell because it does not have a definite nucleus with a clear nuclear membrane. At the same time, the higher organisms carry eukaryotic cells. That means eukaryotic cell has a definite nucleus with a clear nuclear membrane. Look here. These are some pictures of non-living and living things. You can easily classify them into living and non-living things categories. But the question is that, what are the characteristic features of living things which differ from non-living things? Let us see some important characters of living things. First, growth. What is growth? Growth means it is increase in body mass by cell division. A mountain increases in size over time. Is it growth or not? No, this is not growth in the biological sense, because it is merely increase in size. But in biology, growth means it is increase in size or mass by cell division or by accumulation of protoplasm. The second characteristic feature of living thing is reproduction. There are two types of reproduction, asexual and sexual. Asexual means there is a merely division of the body, like binary fission as in amoeba, or budding in Hydra, like that. Sexual means there should be sex cells like gametes in the reproduction. We say all organisms reproduce, but see, mule. Mule is a hybrid of donkey and horse, but mule cannot reproduce. That means it is a sterile organism. Take another example, worker bees, which are also unable to reproduce. Aren't they living things? Yes, they are living things, but they cannot reproduce. Another feature of living thing is metabolism. What is metabolism? Every second in the cell of an organism, large number of chemical reactions takes place. Sum total of all these reactions is called metabolism. Metabolism can be divided into anabolism and catabolism. Anabolism means it is a building up reaction. That is, something is produced. For example, photosynthesis. Carbohydrate is produced by reacting carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight. So, something is produced, that is anabolic reaction. Second type is catabolism. Here, a macromolecule, a big molecule, is broken down to smaller ones. For example, respiration. Then there is a question. Can you conduct metabolic reactions in the laboratory? Yes, we can conduct metabolic reactions in the laboratory. But a series of metabolic reactions, a chain reactions, not easy to be carried out in the laboratory. Yes, it occurs in our cells, like glycolysis, Krebs cycles, and so on. Response is another character of every living thing. See, every organism responds to external stimulus. Next character is movement. You know, all organisms cannot move from one place to another place. But in the cell of every organism, there is a movement. For example, movement of cytoplasm. Another feature of living thing is evolution. Evolution simply means it is a type of adjustment into the changes occur in the surroundings. See, in microorganisms, many evolutionary changes are visible to us. But in higher organisms, it occurs for a long period of time. So, usually it is not visible. Then death is another feature of living thing. What is death? It is stopping body functions forever. Our body functions stop. They cannot be reversed. Then there is a question. A man who is in coma, coma means prolonged unconscious state, with brain death, is living or non-living? A man who is in coma with brain death state is living or non-living? Of course, the man is living. Only the brain is not functioning, but other organ systems may be working, or the cells are functioning. So, clinically speaking or biologically speaking, the man is living. Another question, are some organisms like amoeba and hydra immortals? That means they do not die? In one sense, they do not die. For example, if amoeba reproduces by binary fission, you know, the body of amoeba splits into two pieces. Each piece develops into a full amoeba. What happens to the parent amoeba? Does it die? No. Take another example, hydra. Budding is a type of reproduction in hydra. That means a small projection arises from the body of hydra. Then it is split off and it becomes a full hydra. What happens to the parent hydra? It does not die? No. But, you know, if a pond is dried up, we know the amoeba and hydra, all other organisms in the pond may die. That is a kind of death. Respiration is the another character of living thing. Respiration simply means an energy releasing process. It may occur in the presence of oxygen or absence of oxygen. If it occurs in the presence of oxygen, such respiration is called aerobic respiration. For example, in higher animals and plants, the aerobic respiration occurs. That means energy releases with the presence of oxygen. But in many microorganisms, the anaerobic respiration occurs. Anaerobic respiration means the releasing energy in the absence of oxygen. For example, yeast can respire anaerobically. The bacteria Lactobacillus that can respire anaerobically. Another important feature of living thing is presence of nucleic acid and protein. Nucleic acid, as we know, RNA and DNA are main nucleic acids. RNA or DNA or both are found in every living thing. Then protein. Protein is found in every organism. Cellular organization is a feature of living things. That means the body of organism may contain a single cell or many cells, as we discussed earlier. Amoeba and paramecium carries one cell, so it is unicellular. Then many animals, organisms like sponges, mammals and plants carry many cells in their body, so they are called multicellular organisms. Again, the cells may join to form tissues, tissues join to form organs, and organs to organ systems in the higher animals. Next, let us see the diversity of organisms. That is amazing and wonderful. That is biodiversity. Biodiversity refers to the number and types of organisms on Earth. As we know, varieties of organisms are there. 1.7 to 1.8 million species are known and described so far. So, this is wonderful. Next, we have to see what is nomenclature. Giving a name to an organism is very important. So, nomenclature means giving a standard name to an organism which has been accepted all over the world. There is a system of naming called binomial nomenclature. It refers to providing name to an organism, and the name has two components. That is, we call binomial, naming an organism with two components. For example, Mangifera indica is the binomial of mango tree. The first component, that is Mangifera, is the genus part, and second component, indica, is the species part. That means a scientific name or zoological or botanical name should consist of two components. First part, genus part, and second is species part. Then Panthera tigris, that is a scientific name of tiger. Panthera is the genus and tigris is the species. Plants are named based on the principle of ICBN. ICBN means International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. The animals are based on ICZN. This is expanded as International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. There are some rules of nomenclature. The name, that means the binomial, should be in Latin or derived from Latin. For example, indica is derived from Latin. Second rule, the first word is genus. For example, Mangifera indica, Mangifera is the genus name, and second one is species, that is indica is the species name. The third rule, both the words should be underlined if handwritten or in italics if printed. Next rule, the genus part should start with a capital letter. See Mangifera, M is capital, and a species part with small letter. See Indica, I is small. Next rule, the author's name comes after species name. For example, Mangifera indica Linnaeus. See Linnaeus comes after species name, which means the species was first described by Linnaeus. Next, classification. It is making groups or categories of organisms based on some characters. For example, we can classify the animals like this: a group of mammals, birds, herbs, shrubs, and trees. These are categories: mammals categories, birds category, fishes, herbs, shrubs, and trees are all categories of organisms. The categories are called taxa. That means mammals, birds, fishes, etc. are taxa. Singular taxon, that means mammals is a taxon. Then taxonomy. The process of classification is called taxonomy. Taxonomists consider the external and internal characters, structure of cells, ecology, and even DNA structure of the organism for classification. All these are considered by taxonomists for classification. Next, systematics. It has a broad meaning. See, this branch of biology deals with not only the classification of organisms, but also the relationship among them. Relationship means evolutionary relationships. All the organisms have relationships. Then another features of systematics. It includes identification of an organism, the nomenclature, that means giving a name, then classification. Other important concept is hierarchical classification, which means the classification includes a series of steps from kingdom to species, and the steps are called categories. Let us see the categories. Kingdom, phylum. If it is plant, instead of phylum there is division. Then class, order, family, genus, and species. These are called categories. From kingdom to species, different categories. So this is the hierarchical classification. Let us start with the first category, that is kingdom. What is a kingdom? All animals are classified as kingdom Animalia because they have many common characters, and all the plants belong to the kingdom Plantae since they share many common characters. Next category is phylum. All the animals in the kingdom are not alike. So, the animals with some common characters are grouped into different phyla, singular phylum. For example, the kingdom Animalia has phylum Chordata and non-Chordata. Phylum Chordata has a notochord in the embryo stage or in the adult, and non-chordate without a notochord. That is, notochord is absent in non-chordata and present in chordata. So what is a notochord? Notochord is a flexible rod-like structure found lower side to the nerve cord. Yes, we can see the notochord in this picture. See this picture. This picture actually shows the important features of phylum Chordata, but here you can see the position of notochord. that is ventral to the dorsal hollow nerve cord. That means nerve cord is dorsal to the notochord, notochord is ventral to the nerve cord, that is lower to the nerve cord. The presence of this notochord shows that the organism is a chordate. See, fishes, amphibians, birds and mammals belong to phylum Chordata. That means these are all categories. And the lower organisms like sponges, coelenterates, etc. are non-chordates. There is a question. Does the adult human possess a notochord? No. We have a vertebral column. But we belong to chordata. Why? The reason is that our embryo stage has a notochord. That is why we are chordates. The plants with some common features are grouped into division instead of phylum. Example, Angiospermae. Next category in the hierarchical classification is class. All the animals in the phyla are not alike. So, the animals with some common features are grouped into class. For example, Pisces, that is fishes, amphibia, reptilia, aves and mammalia are classes of phylum Chordata. Next category is order. The organisms in a class with some similar features are grouped into order. For example, carnivore is an order. Carnivore means flesh-eating animals. Herbivore means the animals are plant-eating. See the plants. Poales is an order of class Monocotyledonae, then family. Many members in a given order share some similar features which are grouped into families. For example, Felidae is a family of order Carnivore. In plants, Poaceae is a family of the order Poales. Next category is genus. The animals in a family share some similar features which are grouped into the category genus, plural genera. For example, Panthera is a genus of lion and tiger of the family Felidae. Both lion and tiger as the genus name Panthera. Then Solanum is a genus of potato and brinjal of family Solanaceae. That means both potato and brinjal has the genus name Solanum. Next, species. Some members of the genus share some unique features from other members, so they are divided into different species. That means all members in the genus are not alike. For example, lion and tiger in the same genus, Panthera, but possess some of its own characters. That means lion and tiger are not alike. So, lion belongs to the species Leo and tiger belongs into Tigris, that species. That means tiger and lion both are included in the same genus Panthera because of some common characters. Again, lion has its own characters. Tigress, that means tiger has its own characters. So, lion is Leo and tiger is Tigris. These are species names. See in plants, potato and brinjal belong to same genus Solanum. But potato is different from brinjal in some features. So, species of potato is tuberosum and brinjal is Melonchini. Remember, genus and species names together make a scientific name. See some scientific names or zoological names. Panthera tigris, that is a zoological name of tiger. Panthera leo, that is a zoological name of lion. Solanum tuberosum, that is a scientific name of potato. Solanum melongene, that is a scientific name or botanical name of brinjal. See here, these are organisms come under kingdom Animalia. See leeches here, then prawn, starfish, shark, tree frog, cobra, parrot, lion and tiger. All these organisms come under kingdom Animalia. But see, all have different characters also. See here, leech, prawn and starfish are classified under non-chordata because they don't have notochord. At the same time, other animals come under phylum chordata. All these animals have notochord. Again, the chordates have many different characters, so they have to divide another category. See various classes. The class Pisces, fish, then class Amphibia, then class Reptilia, class Aves, then class Mammalia. These are all mammals. But see, all these mammals have some different characters. So these mammals are divided orders, order Carnivora. Both lion and dog are carnivores. That means they are flesh eating. Again, tiger has some of its own characters. Lion has its own characters. Both of them have some common characters. So, lion and tiger are included in the same family, that is Felidae. Then see, dog has some different characters from the lion and tiger. So, this is included another family, that is Canidae. Of course, deer and elephant have some common characters. At the same time, they have some different characters. So, deer is included in the family Cervidae and elephant is included in the family Elephantidae. Again, even though lion and tiger are included in the same family, it has some common characters again. So, both are included in the same genus, that is Panthera. But lion has its own characters, tiger has its own characters. So, they are divided into two different species. That means the species of lion is leo, the species of tiger is tigris. This is the hierarchical classification we discussed so far. These are categories of hierarchical classification, starting from species, ending at kingdom. That is, species is the basic unit of classification. So, species is a category, genus, family, order, class, phylum in the case of animals, division in the case of plants, and kingdom are all categories of hierarchical classification. See this table. You can see the classification of man, housefly, mango tree and wheat. In the first column, you can see the common name. For example, man. Biological name of man is Homo sapiens. That is, species name is sapiens and genus name is Homo. Family of man is Hominidae. Order of man is Primata. Man belongs to the class Mammalia and phylum Chordata. Next, look at housefly. Biological name of housefly is Musca domestica. Its species name is Domestica, genus Musca. Family is the Musidae. Then order Diptera. The class of housefly is Insecta. And phylum of housefly is Arthropoda. Next, mango tree. The biological name of mango tree is Mangifera indica. Species name is Indica, genus is Mangifera. Family of mango, that is Anacardiaceae. Then order Sapintails. Division is Angiospermae. Then wheat. Biological name of wheat is Triticum aestivum. Then species is aestivum. The genus of wheat is Triticum. The family of wheat is Poaceae. Wheat belongs to the order Poales. The class of wheat is Monocotyledonae and division is Angiospermae. Then taxonomical aids. You know, for identification of an animal or plant, first we have to go into field for collection of some plants and animals. That is very helpful to identify the animal. We can bring back the animals collected or plants collected to laboratory and then we can identify them. But you know, there are many techniques and procedures for taxonomic study. These are taxonomical aids, and also there are many techniques and procedures to store the information we collected so far. The first taxonomic aid is herbarium. You know, herbarium is a storehouse of collected plants that are dried, pressed and preserved on sheets. You can see herbarium sheets here. The herbarium sheets carries a label with a date and place of collection, then English, local and botanical names. Then there is also family name and collector's names on this label. You can see the herbarium sheets here. Another taxonomical aid is botanical garden. The gardens have plants for study. The plants are grown in this garden for study purpose. The plants are labeled indicating its botanical name and its family. There will be labelings on the plants. One of the famous botanical gardens is Kew Garden in England. Indian Botanical Garden is situated in Howrah, West Bengal. Then National Botanical Research Institute is in Lucknow. These two are important botanical gardens in India. Then museum. Biological museums have collections of preserved plants and animals for the study and reference. See, in museum, the animals are kept in jars in preservatives. Usually preservatives are some chemicals that prevent the spoiling of the animals collected. Plants and some animals are dry specimens. Then insects kept in insect boxes. You can see here the insect boxes. Birds and large animals are kept as stuffed specimens. Birds and many animals can be stuffed by removing the internal organs and flesh and by filling some cotton inside. That is the process is called stuffing. Then zoological parks, another taxonomical aid. Animals are protected and cared here, providing the conditions as far as possible similar to the natural habitats. See here, the animals are living in the zoological parks as far as possible in natural habitats. You know, this helps us to study the habits and behaviors of these animals, birds, in almost natural conditions. key is the another taxonomical aid. See here some important characters of a key. Keys are used for identification of plants and animals. Then key has a pair of contrasting characters called a couplet. Then one choice of the pair is accepted and other is rejected. We can see here a simple example. You got an organism, but unknown to you. You had to identify it. Then you examine it closely. You make a keys like that. For example, three pair of legs, present or absent? Yes, present. Then you can see the given organism is an insect. Next couplet, two pair of wings, present or absent? Yes, present. You can say this is a winged insect. Again, large colorful wings, present or absent? Present. You can say this is butterfly or moth. You are not sure, so you have to make another key. Feather-like antenna, present or absent? Yes, present. You can identify the organism as moth. So you identify the organism as moth based on all these characters or statements. These are statements of a key. See here, a moth and butterfly. Look at the antenna of moth, that is feather-like. Flora is another taxonomical aid. This is a publication. It is an actual account of distribution and habitats of plants or a particular group like orchid or fern in a given area. Then the flora also helps to identify the plants based on some characters or key points. Then the flora has an index of plants in a given region. You can see some examples of flora here. Flora indica or descriptions of Indian plants. Then the flora of British India, volume 2. Then the flora of Andhra Pradesh. These are some examples for flora. Then manuals. Manuals have detailed description of a specimen with a wider scope. Then monograph. It is a record of comprehensive study of a group of specimen, usually a genus or a family. It is usually a worldwide study. Then catalogue is another type of taxonomical aid. It is listing of holding of libraries or list of reference books or institutions related to the taxonomic study. This is called a catalogue. Then let us see some questions related to the topic we discussed so far. First question. Match the items in column 1 with column 2 and choose the correct answer. Column 1, A, Musidae. Column 2, Housefly. B, Nymphalidae. 2, Butterfly. C, Hominidae. 3, Man. D, Felidae. 4, Lion. You can see, in the column 1, all are families. In the column 2, all are examples of organisms. The options are A, A1 and C4, B, B2 and A3, C, C3, D1 and B2, D, A1, B2, C3 and D4, then E, A1, B3, C2 and D4. the explanation and answer to the question. All the items in the column 1 match with the items in the column 2. So the correct answer is D. A1, B2, C3 and D4. See again. So D is the correct answer. A1, that is Musidae, housefly. B2, Nymphalidae, butterfly. C3, Hominidae, man. And D4, Felidae, lion. Look at the second question. Which of the following is the scientific name of housefly? The options are A. Musca albina, B. Musca domestica, C. Musca amita, D. Musca bisetta, E. Musca lucidula. We can see the explanation and answer to the question. A, C, D, E are the scientific names of various species of flies, but the scientific name of housefly is Musca domestica. So the correct answer is Musca domestica, that is B. You can see here, B is the Musca domestica. Then third question. Raju collected a starfish during a seashore visit. Which is the proper place to store the specimen for future study? Read the options. A. Zoo. B. Zoological park. C. Herbarium. D. Museum. E. National park. See the explanation and answer. It is in the museum where the collected animals are preserved and kept for future reference and study. So the correct answer is museum. C. D is the correct answer. That is museum where starfish is to be stored. Then fourth question. Kew Garden is situated in A. Option New York, B. London, C. Tokyo, D. Paris, E. Washington. Where Kew Garden is situated. You can see the explanation and answer to the question. The famous Kew Botanical Garden is situated in London. So the correct answer is London. See here, B is the correct answer. Then fifth question. Systema Naturae is written by Gregor Mendel, A option. Then B, Darwin. C, Linnaeus. D, Hugo de Vries. E, Jesse Bos. Yes, you can see the explanation and answer. Carolus Linnaeus is the author of Systema Naturae. So, the correct answer is C, Linnaeus. See here, Systema Naturae is written by Linnaeus. Look at the sixth question. Pick out the correct pair from following. A option, Darwin-physiology, B, Gregor Mendel-evolution, C, Jesse Bos-genetics, Linnaeus-taxonomy, Hugo de Vries-anatomy. See the explanation and answer. Darwin conducted studies on evolution. Mendel and de Vries worked on genetics. J.C. Bos mainly focused on plant physiology. Linnaeus conducted studies on taxonomy of plants. So the correct answer is Linnaeus taxonomy pair, that is D. C. Darwin physiology, that is wrong. Rigor Mendel evolution, that is also wrong. J.C. Bos genetics, not true. Linnaeus taxonomy, that is the correct answer. Hugo de Vries anatomy is also wrong option. Read the seventh question. Consider the following statements regarding the taxonomic aids and choose the wrong one. In the zoological park, animals are kept in almost a natural habitat. B. Key is used to identify a species based on similar characters. C. Plants are dried and kept in herbarium for future study. D. Flora gives an account of plants in a region. E. Catalogue consists of references of publication. Here is the explanation and answer. Key is used to identify a species based on contrasting pair of characters. So, the correct answer is B. Key is used to identify a species based on similar characters. That is wrong. So, you have to select the wrong one. That is B. Key is used to identify a species based on similar characters. Then, 8th question. Indian Botanical Garden is situated in A option, that is Lucknow, B Calcutta, C New Delhi, D Mumbai, E Howrah. See the explanation and answer. Indian Botanical Garden is situated in Howrah, West Bengal. So, the correct answer is Howrah. That is E. Indian Botanical Garden is situated in Howrah. Here is the 9th question. National Botanical Research Institute is situated in A option Ooty, B Mumbai, C Bangalore, D Lucknow, E Howrah. Yes, here is the explanation and answer. National Botanical Research Institute is situated in Lucknow. So, the correct answer is D Lucknow. That is D Lucknow. This is the 10th and last question. Read the following statements and choose the correct option. The first option A. Mango belongs to the family Poales. B option. Wheat belongs to the family Anacardiaceae. C. Man belongs to the order Hominidae. D. Mango belongs to the order Sapindales. E. Housefly belongs to the class Dipterae. Read the following statements and choose the correct option. Yes. We can see the explanation answer. The order of mango trees Sapindales. So, the correct answer is D. Mango belongs to the order Sapindales. See here. D. Mango belongs to the order Sapindales. These are the important ideas we have discussed the first unit of the first year zoology part, that is the living world. You have understood some features regarding the classification, nomenclature and taxonomical aids. Then you have to understand more and more and read well, understand more, then win your race. Thank you very much.